Microphone muted.
One of the things that I think we're going to look for a lot today is definitely going to be tire wear. You want to make sure that you protect your right front tire, and you'll see a lot of movers and shakers out there, especially guys that are trying to practice tires early in a run and keep heat out of them. But overall, a lot of it's, and there's not a whole lot of fuel strategy today. They can go a little over 35 laps, so they can make it. They can make it past halfway for sure. It will be a one-stop race if you aren't crazy on your fuel. And here they roll off the grid. We're going to see, I think, restarts are going to mean a lot if we get a lot of them. It's not easy to get power down, especially early on cold tires. You do have more grip, but there's going to be a lot of jostling for position, especially if you restart on old tires. It's going to be really interesting to see how they pull it through turns 1 and 2. Microphone active. There's going to be a lot of interesting maneuvers. Looks like we almost had an incident on the grid right there.
I was just going to ask you, we see David Fish get in the back of the 9 of Randy Roberts. Randy's going to swerve after that incident into the 12 of David Shutt. Certainly not the comeback Fish was looking for. This is the first time we've seen him on track for a while now, and not the best way to start things off, but here's what I was going for. We see qualifying here. We see Randy Roberts having a really good qualifying run, starting in the 6th spot. Are you at all surprised to see Randy Roberts up there almost in the top 5 to start the race?
Not as particularly, as if I would be surprised at a place like, Phoenix or a short track, because this place is almost wide open on your qualifying lap. So it's a lot like Daytona or Talladega qualifying. It'll be smooth, and there's a little bit of lifting in 3 and 4 to really hit a great lap and get the arc, but it's not that hard to run a decent lap here. The hard part here is running in traffic around other cars. The way the banking is and the way the track is so wide, you feel like you got a room into racing grind. The racing groove is actually really skinny.
Wow, Riley, that's really cool. The green flag is out here at Sim Racing Authority TV. They're going to go 3 wide at the turn 1. Tyler Ducharme looking to the high side of the 59 of Alex Peck. David Shutt on the bottom there, the 69 of Tyler Ducharme is going to get back in line behind, is that Fox or Buffalo Wild Wing? It's both. Okay, I got confused
both
there. What the fuck? Who paints that? Yeah, I'm in a car with Fox and Buffalo Wild Wings. Meanwhile, Marcus
Richardson. I'm going to do a motocross double backflip over a fucking Buffalo Wild Wing. That's what I'm going to do after this race.
The Marcus Richardson, he is your leader right now in the discount tire Ford. Second place is David Shutt in the Travis Pastrana machine. As they wreck behind him, Simpson. Oh, my God.
Well, there goes my pick for this week.
Oh.
Oh, Matt Simpson very quickly all F4ing out of the race out of frustration and shame.
What happened there? Taking a look at the chase view. Oh, that was all triggered by none other than Tyler Ducharme. Here we see Tyler Ducharme. He's going to get in the back bumper.
Normally I would completely agree with you, but on my screen I'm not seeing that at all.
The 59 got loose either way. To me it looked like Ducharme got in the back of him. Then he gets loose, gets into the 33 of Matt Simpson. Simpson left with nowhere to go. He is going to overcorrect, slide way up the track, get the 4 of Connor Anton. There is Kraft Dinner all over the racetrack. That's the 62 of Nicholas Caressel. An absolute shitload of cars involved.
Yeah, that's a tough break for a lot of guys. Those are a lot of fast guys caught up in that. Connor Anton, not good to see him go so early. Matt Simpson, one of his favorite tracks, taken out early. Looks like Alex Peck just got loose. I'm frustrated with Ducharme right behind him, and that's not just typical Atlanta race. That's something I was worried about happening. Get loose and race around traffic. Like I said, place not hard on your own, really hard in traffic.
Should we have a chat with Matt Simpson? That'd be a bad idea. I don't know.
He's not even in a race anymore, so good luck. You can drag him down here and talk to him if you want, but probably already up from his computer smoking a bowl.
Matt Simpson, you got a copy, sir.
10-4.
Well, you're having a real nice run out there for at least 2 laps. It looked to me like Tyler Ducharme got in the back bumper of the 59 of Alex Peck, absolutely destroyed your car. There's Kraft Dinner all over the racetrack. It needs to be cleaned up. Track crews are attending to that right now. What exactly happened from your perspective?
Actually, I think we only made it 1 lap.
Oh.
But, yeah, basically, I guess, It was time to get to the front for some people, and ended up junking most of the field there.
I would agree. Anyone you'd like to thank sponsor-wise? Anyone you'd like to say fuck you to? Anything like that?
I got to thank Morgan Shepherd.
Did you see
Tyler Ducharme?
Did you see Morgan Shepherd singing "Shepherd of Fire" before the race?
I did not. I can't wait for the highlight though.
Yeah, that's gonna be a highlight. Okay, I'm gonna pull you back up. Who was in your channel?
Bobby and Austin.
10-4. User was moved out of your channel. Well, that's the word right there. That went really well. Surprisingly well. Let's talk with our in-race reporter. Hang on. Is he even on the track? Yeah, he's bringing his car out of the pit lane right now. Let's talk with our in-race reporter, Aaron Davis, shall we? User was moved to your Davis, we see you out there in the Boris Said machine painted by Stuart Redmond Designs right there. It's an absolutely beautiful work of art that you're driving out there today. Tell us a little bit about what your game plan is here tonight. We saw you having a decent run there at Homestead last night, which was a first. You could take Beach out right now if you wanted to, and you might be safe for the rest of the night.
Yeah, but my car, I'm not really fast here, so I'm just planning on surviving right now.
You mean you're really, really, really slow is what you're getting at?
Yeah, I'm really bad, so I just want to survive this race. I missed that wreck. You just had to stop in the middle of the track. Couldn't do anything, so... I was pretty,
So
pretty
from
early
your amazing perspective in the back of the field behind literally everybody else, how do you think this race is developing so far?
Well, it's developed by a bunch of skill that happened down in turn 1 and 2.
Very sure, yes, exactly. Yes,
primarily by Tyler Ducharme.
Yes, much wow on that. So, yeah. Very uneventful so far because we're on lap 5 and half the field is gone, so...
Yeah. Taking a look on board with Aaron Davis as he's going to work his way through this incident. There they go, cars in the wall everywhere, getting on the brakes, everyone behind him getting on the brakes. And he's going to slide
like
to the
people.
Bottom, go through the grass, get on through there. And nice job missing the wreck right there by Aaron Davis. Unfortunately, you did not come in like a wrecking ball. We wanted to see some more replays of the wreck right there. How surprised are you that Tyler Ducharme caused a wreck within the first lap?
No, I can say I'm fairly not surprised.
Yeah. Are you guys about to go green?
Yeah.
I feel like you're about to go green.
Yes, we are 1 to green right
okay,
now. I don't know what David Shedd is doing.
Okay, that's nice. Bye-bye. You were in the channel with Connor, right?
Yes, I was. User was
moved out of your channel. That's all the answer I need. I'll need your shit. Thank God.
Wait, professional and ask if the 1 to green was out, Stuart.
Shut
up. Pace car, you scrub.
I don't care. I was looking at replays, man.
You're so worthless. Microphone muted. Here we go for another restart coming around 3 and 4. And again, we're going to look for some interesting position changes. A lot of three wide, a lot of guys can get up and go on these restarts, and some of the guys, I don't know if anybody stayed out. I don't remember, that was Stewart's job, he didn't pay any attention. I'm pretty sure...
What's that supposed to mean? I think Marcus might have stayed out.
If any of these guys stayed out, you gotta watch this restart. It'd be a drag race down into 1 and 2, and it's really hard to get grip of 1 and 2 on even one lap old tire.
There goes Riley Wyans talking over the green flag again, but the green flag
no
is flown here at Atlanta. I care, that's all that matters. The 69 of Tyler Ducharme triggering the wreck, but go figure, he's still on the track in the second spot right there, right on the back bumper almost, of Marcus Richardson. Yet again, the two NASCAR The Game hacks are leading the field here in Atlanta. I don't even know what is real anymore. David Shutt's in third. This track sucks. Marcus is leading. Tyler's in second. Third is David Shutt. Fourth is Beach. And apparently fifth is Aaron Davis. In the sixth spot, we see Sergio Oliveira in that number 11 machine. Seventh is Tyler Sifford. Eighth is Brian Wortman. Holy crap. Ninth is Trevor Pertelli. Tenth is Bobby Chaney. 11th is Nick Caressel. 12th is Mark Arthur. 13th is that Randy Roberts. Does appear to be a little...
You know you're looking at a long run when you see your first side-by-side battle back in 8th.
Yeah, that is for sure.
I don't think Bobby Chaney's happy where he's at back there in what looks like 10th.
Yeah, it does.
I think
appear.
He really wants to get past these two in front of him, but I don't think he can get anywhere around him with the arrow disadvantage he's got back there. It's going to be interesting to see if he gets past, if he can catch his lead pack up front, having a little bit of clean air, but not having a draft. So I think, you know, if he gets past these two guards, it'll tell us a tale if these guys can make up any ground on a longer run.
Bobby Chaney absolutely trapped behind the number 89 Racing for Jesus Ford, it appears. It appears Morgan Shepherd has made some upgrades to his race team, gotten some sponsorship money directly from Jesus himself, and he's purchased a Ford Mustang now instead of his Chevy Impala. Good to see that Morgan Shepherd is moving up in the world. They are side by side. Morgan Shepherd side by side with the 7 of Trevor Pertelli. But Bobby Chaney absolutely stuck back there, as is the 62 of Nick Caressel, who must have pulled off an amazing save, because I saw him sideways avoiding
He's
that
wreck. He's
definitely
got some damage on the back of that car.
You got damage on the back of your car.
It's not even out there, that's true.
That's why it's not out there. Friggin' crashed through the garage area.
I know, some fuck ran into with a bike.
No, you ran into the hot dog concession.
Oh, I ran into the hot dog stand, then hit Landon Castle on his motorcycle.
Oh, that's understandable. Microphone muted.
Wow, a rare sight up at the front of the field, not Marcus Richardson leading.
Microphone activated. Incorrect. Actually, a rare sight at the front of the field. Your leader is Tyler Ducharme. I know. We just assume that Marcus is leading all the time, but no, Marcus Richardson falling back now. We see David Shutt to the outside of Marcus Richardson. I think Richardson's going to be able to hold on to the second spot. But Tyler Ducharme in the number 69 Elliott Henderson Graphics Ford is your leader. He causes a wreck, takes out all the fast cars. That's how he gets good finishes. Good job, Tyler Ducharme.
It looks like Tyler's able to get past it when Marcus entered too high into 3 and 4 and got off the line and pretty much got freight trained by second and third place Ducharme and Shutt, and it looks like he's going to start working his way back up to Ducharme's rear bumper. I wouldn't expect Tyler to get out very, very far ahead due to the draft that Marcus is going to get, although it might make Marcus work his right front a little bit harder than he wants.
Now, let me tell you, what you're saying sounds really important and stuff, but you know what's even more important than what you're saying?
What?
Aaron Davis is in the top 5 right now.
You're right, that actually is more important, because that's the first time that's ever happened.
Actually, he's got his new computer now. Last night, he was running a second when he got wrecked at Homestead.
Oh, wow.
Does
he realize how ugly all your paint schemes are now that he has a new computer and he can actually see
them? What are you talking about? My paint scheme is amazing. Just look at it going around the track. Like, look at it from TV3 in the
I can
Triumph.
See the doge eyes from Blimp View. Yeah. It's amazing.
Just look at that shit from TV3. It's awesome. Don't mess with the Doge, man. Don't mess with the Doge. That's why he's faster. This is one of the first times he's run this Doge paint with Boris Said embodied on the front of the vehicle, and I think that's where he's showing his speed as we see Marcus Richardson right on the back bumper of Tyler Ducharme and Mr. Beach right on the back bumper of David Shutt. We see Richardson making the move right there in turn one, absolutely blowing by Tyler Ducharme. Tyler Ducharme might even lose second here to the 12 of David Shutt as they work their way down the backstretch into turn number 3.
One thing for sure is you're not going to see this front pack depart very much. It races a lot like a super speedway as far as racing everyone else until you get side by side due to how fast this track is and the amount of downforce in these cars.
What you're saying is accurate as we see Sergio Oliveira now closing in on this pack. It was 5 cars, now it's going to be 6 if they stay side by side here for a few more laps at Atlanta. David Shutt still on the inside of the 69 of Tyler Ducharme. Mr. Beach right there in the green, the Grand Theft Auto 5 machine. And right behind him is the Boris Said Chevy of A.A. Ron Davis. On board with the Boris Said Chevy. Up ahead here, you see the number 22 of Mr. Beach right there. Directly behind him.
He's right there.
Yeah, he's right there. Right now.
That's exactly where he is.
Right here. Right now. Wow, Aaron's gonna wreck him at this point. He's driving it in deep.
I think Aaron might wreck him.
I think he might. It's entirely possible.
Could there be some bad blood from last night? I mean, I don't know, Aaron, he's never fast enough to give payback. I don't know if he's feeling empowered or
what. I don't
know,
dude.
I wouldn't put it past him right now.
Look at that. He is there right there. He's right on the back bumper of Mr. Beach. He's going to tap the apron, stay in the gas like an idiot, and hit the wall.
Wow. Well, the computer didn't help his bad driving.
God
damn
it.
I also like to point out that Mr. French Beach is the first Chevrolet in the field, even though these cars are exactly identical via physics.
Hey, Davis.
Hey.
Why do you suck so bad?
What do you mean?
I was on board with you. We were psyched to see you in the top five. You hit the apron, and then you stay in the gas and hit the wall.
I lifted off the gas, by the way.
How does it feel to still suck at iRacing?
Are you in the top six right now?
I could wreck the top six right now.
that's a very accurate statement.
Yeah, that's, but you,
speaking
you know,
of the top
I
six right now, how about
skills.
Randy Roberts? You're up on him, and I'm interested in actually making you wreck the whole field and talking to you while you're racing right now.
Your car is screwed, dude. You're going to be way off the pace. All right, you're done.
Screwed? It
Peace
is?
Out, bro.
Really?
He seriously
I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure he was screwed when you put Boris Set on the hood. That fro is going to slow him down a lot.
Well, I'm pretty sure he is actually screwed, though, because even if you just tap the wall and this... Oh, as he passes Sergio Oliveira. But usually with this car, even if you just tap the wall, you are significantly at a disadvantage with that damage. There's something about this car in Atlanta with the new iRacing damage model. It will just eat you up and spit you out. Contact between the 32 and the 11 right there as they work their way into turn one. They are going to lose that lead group right now. But Marcus Richards...
This lead pack is now dealing with some lap traffic with Randy Roberts. Looks like David Fish is merging in 3 and 4. He might stay out of the way. Discretion, better part of valor. There's, Randy Roberts is racing really, really hard to keep his lap. Oh my god,
Oh my god,
that was incredible.
Dude, Randy Roberts is the best. Randy Roberts.
That was that's the best racing I've seen all afternoon. It was a lap car.
Randy Roberts for Rookie of the Year. We see the 32 of Aaron Davis. He's pretty unhappy right now. We see him right on the back bumper, the 11 of Sergio Oliveira.
He's butthurt.
He's a little butthurt. Either way, you got to give him credit. Usually he's in last place and he hits the wall and screws his race. This time he was...
If you saw his practice time and his practice laps, the fact that he hasn't hit the wall again is actually pretty impressive for him. And I think he's actually, you know, getting this track down fairly good for himself.
It certainly is a turning point in the career of Aaron Davis. Maybe he's going to be one of those drivers who peaks later in their career like Derek Cope or Morgan Shepherd. Right?
Well, as long as he never quits, he'll make it. That's all it takes.
Meanwhile, Richards is still your leader, but the draft lock is still there, and it is showing Tyker in the second spot. Third is Mr. Beach. Fourth, I can count, is David Shutt. And the fifth spot now belongs to the 11 of Sergio Oliveira, as we see the 32 working by some lap traffic, the 9 of Randy Roberts.
This just in, Master Lock has announced their sponsorship for this race because the entire top four haven't been separated more than a second this entire time. It's not because of talent, because Tyler Ducharme is in second. Goes to show, if you want your field to stick together, put them a mile and a half and put them in a car with less than 900 horsepower. It works really good every single time.
I agree. Thank you very much for joining us here at Sim Racing Authority TV. Bob Train, Canton 4, Catfish, KMNCO07. Lachlan, Shut. Thank you very much for tuning in. We do appreciate you joining us. SimRacingAuthority.com. You can find links to our Twitter and Facebook. Follow us, like us there, of course. That's when you're going to know when we are going kneel to the wheel racing here at Sim Racing Authority TV and get some really important updates. SimRacingAuthorityTV.com. If you'd like to join the leagues, we have a Gen 6 league, a nationwide league, and a national car league. They're all
leagues are important. Boo-hoo, boo-hoo, boo-hoo. Tyler Ducharme getting passed by Beach and David Shutt here off the corner.
I'm just doing my job, man.
The racing is going to make them join, Stewart. Maybe. But Marcus Richardson's now starting to pull away from these back three cars after they shuffled it up. I'm not sure exactly what happened to Tyler. I think he might have got a little tight. The one thing I noticed is these guys have moved up off the bottom in 1 and 2.
Marcus certainly didn't get tight.
Yeah. These guys are running the middle lane now in 1 and 2, at least on entry, as opposed to being right down that white line. As the tires wear, I think you're going to see a little bit more of a midline around this racetrack rather than hugging the bottom. maybe not all on purpose, because these guys are right, they're not right on the white line like they were earlier. And I really don't know how to get around this place very good. They might not have been earlier. I don't pay attention. Fuck me. I'll let Stewart take care of that. But if we see Marcus get away here, I don't think we're going to see him again.
Yeah. You know, what you're saying is really important. I just had a bit of a nostalgia moment. I remember these B cars in Atlanta, and I like league racing here. I actually got kicked out of a league once at Atlanta in the B cars. I was going at a top speed. You could almost say it was the car's largest amount or possibly maximum speed of the car when suddenly I said the word "God dang it," and then I got banned forever for cussing.
I just got word from Matt Simpson.
Are we adding Jeff Gordon?
We might
to the chase?
Be seeing him reappear on the racetrack.
Really? Who's he wrecking?
Oh man, too much damage for Matt Simpson. I don't know if we will see him back out there, but man,
no,
if he was, I'm getting word that he's not very happy with a very particular driver. It might not end very well.
Is it the 69 of Tyler Ducharme? Because the only other driver he'd be mad at would be the 59 of Alex Peck, and he is off the track.
Well, I mean, Matt is high. He wouldn't know the difference between the two.
Well, if Matt pays me like $10 or something, I'll go on with mouse controls and just take out Tyler Ducharme. Just absolutely kill him. Just dead. Peace out.
Yeah, well, I'm pretty sure his chances of winning are dead because he's now P4 in that line of cars. He's got shut in front of him, so that's a wreck waiting to happen. As you see the smoking husk of a car down in the infield in his pit box for Matt Simpson. And I did notice that Beach reeled back in Marcus, and then Marcus just took off again, just gone out there. So I'm not sure if we're seeing Beach stick with him or if Marcus is playing with us a little bit here.
This really is a concerning pack of cars. Marcus Richardson is leading the pack. He's bad fast, so I mean, you know, that's understandable. Now we have Beach right here, in an unoriginal fashion. People do happen to blame Beach on a lot of things. David Shutt, running in the third spot, he is just an absolute nightmare to drive around. And Tyler Ducharme now about to lose that pack in the fourth spot. So, yeah, it's definitely a concern. Now, Riley, you were bitching at me earlier for
yes.
Promoting the league, promoting the Twitter, promoting the Facebook. Someone is in the stream just followed us on Twitter, which is what I'm getting word from Austin Roberts. So,
yay!
Go fuck yourself. Okay.
Well, see, you don't even have to talk about the shit for him to, you know, follow us.
In the fifth spot now, Bobby Chaney. Where the hell did he come from?
Last.
Aaron Davis, he's gone. He's in the eighth spot now. It looks like there's even more right front damage. Oh, yeah, his car's done. It's toasted. Boris said just absolutely wrinkled there on the number 32 of Aaron Davis. He is holding strong in the
eighth
spot.
I'm getting words that
right
Matt
now.
Simpson has cleared his own black flags, and we might actually end up seeing him back out on the racetrack.
Holy
not sure if he can actually move or not, because that car is de-fucking-stroyed. And Tyler Ducharme is apologizing in race chat. So this could get interesting.
Now, Tyler, we see Matt Simpson clearing his black flags, and then shortly after, you apologize. I understand you're racing, but if you're able to talk enough to apologize, you should be able to talk to me. How concerned are you right now, Tyler?
Not really concerned because I'm not the same driver. I'm just, you know, kind of frustrated myself that I don't even know what happened on the bus. I don't know.
That's very cool. Thank you for talking to us.
Beach is really hounding Richardson still. He has not given up. And you won't see him give up. Even though he is French, he will not give up until the white flag flies. And I think it's going to be hard for Richardson to pull away. As we've been saying, you know, Master Lock sponsored Draft Lock here at Atlanta. You're not going to see this pack separate unless a big mistake is made by one of them.
Yeah. Actually, ever since Master Lock has been sponsoring our Draft Lock races, we actually just got word from them, and it was actually 5 minutes ago they started sponsoring our races. We just got word from them. Their sales have quadrupled of Master Locks. due to the amazing promotion skills here at Sim Racing Authority TV. This line of work, it really is something that is looked upon by myself as helping the community, to help a small, tiny company like Master Lock flourish into the biggest lock company in the world is just... Man. You know, Riley, you know what I'm saying?
You know, what you're saying is really important about all that, but Green Flag Pit Stops will be coming up here pretty soon. They can go about 39 laps on a tank, and it's looking like they're getting around lap 39. I know they had a caution earlier, so they're going to start pitting here really soon if they're pitting early, and I think it's going to be really interesting to see tire strategy and fuel strategy. You're going to pay really close attention to these top three guys, what they do on their stop, because you can take a quick, you got to fill it up. You might as well take four tires, but somebody feels like they can get an edge on two, maybe. Bad idea. These tires do level out after about 10 laps, and you're stuck after 10 laps at the same pace, just about.
Yeah, here we see the number 32, Boris Said Machine, with the Doge on the back, talking about chumps. Aaron Davis down on the pit lane. He is down and away. Let's do a little bit of rewinding here. See what he got on that car. Bringing her down the pit lane, Boris said he's got severe damage to the right side of that machine right here. Gonna get the right side jacked up, taking the right side tires at least. Is he gonna jack up the left side? Yes, four tires for the number 32 machine of Aaron Davis. He might sit here a little bit and get some damage repaired. Yes,
got
he does.
Got some stops starting here that aren't Aaron Davis. Looks like Tyler Ducharme missed pit road. Maybe. David Schutt's definitely on pit road, coming down right now. Looking for the box. Can't see it. Blind. He qualified all the way up there. Jesus. Stops his box, brings to a stop, almost over the line. Right side goes up. Left side goes up. Only four tires and fuel. What I would do.
Right here we see Bobby Chaney in the number 24 Alan Kowicki machine. That's pretty damn unoriginal. Working his way off pit lane. They are side by side off the pit lane.
Bobby took two right side tires, so it'll be interesting to see how him and Schutt work it out these next 4 to 5 to 10 laps here after this pit stop. I have no idea what Stewart has the camera on right now. I'm going to assume it's Bobby and Schutt, because that's the last thing he talked about.
Yes, it is, sir. I'm here, right? Whenever I mute my mic, I'm here. It just means I'm, like, blowing my nose or doing something really, like, unorthodox.
You mute your mic? What are you talking about? Quit breaking the illusion. Just shut the fuck up and talk.
Quit breaking what illusion?
A lot of green flag pit stops going now. 14 down pit road, 52 down pit road, 62 down pit road. No, you have 52 in this series.
You idiot. Gosh, you're breaking the illusion.
Richardson down pit road, Beach down pit road right now. Behind the lap down car of, is that Tyler Sifford? I can't really tell.
That is the number 20 machine. That is Mark Arthur, rather, in the number 20 machine.
Severe damage on that, probably from that first wreck Tyler Charm caused.
Yeah, he's pretty bad.
Richardson, wheel straight on the brake, stops right in his box. We'll see what he gets for tires.
On board with Marcus Richardson on the nose cam. Right side is going to go up, going to drop it off. Richardson, two tires for Marcus Richardson right there. Interesting call, but he's going to come off the pit lane way ahead of Mr. Beach.
Beach on four tires.
Beach taking the four tires. That is going to be interesting to see how that one plays out. Thirty laps to go here at Atlanta.
Brian Wortman, your leader.
Whoa.
Looks like Sergio Oliveira did not enter on the back stretch and is getting a black flag for that. Oh! Brian Wortman gets hit by Beach while entering pit road.
Oh. Ooh.
Severe left front damage on the number 22 Grand Theft Auto 5 machine of Mr. Beach, and that could be race ending for him. No chance to win now.
Wortman pulling off quite the save, though, holding onto that car after getting absolutely decimated by the Frenchman.
So it looks like your running order now after Wortman Pitts is going to be Richardson, Shutt, Chaney, Ducharme. Switch Ducharme and Chaney there. And then Beach, Caressel, Sifford. And then a lap down, Davis, Oliveira, Pertelli, Roberts, Arthur, Fish, Peck, Anton, and Matt Simpson. Out of the race early with damage. Mostly of the wheel persuasion.
Now right here we see Mr. Beach holding on to that fifth spot. Maybe that damage isn't as severe as we thought, as we see him looking to the inside of the 24, Bobby Chaney. Chaney on two tires, Beach on four. It looks like those four tires are going to help him. And Beach is somehow going to make a pass after hitting a car going about 100 miles slower than his own.
Getting word from Bobby Chaney that two tires are fucking horrible. That's a direct quote.
Yeah, that sounds like something you would say.
Yep. Matt Simpson is de facto crew chief, saying, I told you to go with no tires, you moron. He said, well, I took two, and Matt goes, that's horrible. So there's that entire conversation.
That is absolutely insane. Mr. Beach now to the inside of the 69 of Tyler Ducharme. Beach, driving an absolute piece of shit, is now into the third spot.
Oh, damage went away on the 22 machine. Maybe we didn't actually see that information. The correct information.
No, it looked like he nailed him. Like I saw
it does, but the left front damage is now gone. I watched it disappear in front of my eyes, so perhaps there was some lag involved on Wortman. I mean, Beach lives in fucking France. Might have been some lag.
I don't even know what is real anymore. Nonetheless, Beach, now up to the third spot, whether you like it or not. Either way, he had to do some pretty evasive maneuvers. David Shutt, hanging out right there in the second spot. Marcus Richardson absolutely pulling away. He is your leader now by 3.4 seconds over David Shutt, as we see him driving by the number 14 machine of Tyler Sifford. Marcus Richardson right on the back bumper, giving him some pretty intense pressure. He's going to get the run coming off the corner, and here goes Richardson to the inside of Sifford. This is going to put Sifford two laps down.
With Marcus out here on two tires leading the race, working this traffic, Beach is actually the fastest car in the racetrack in his little pack. Last time by, Richardson ran all 30.177, and as he crosses the line, Ducharme, Mr. Beach runs a .104. For those interested, Ducharme ran a .305, so he's nowhere near the fastest car in the racetrack.
Now here we see, most importantly on the track right now, Aaron Davis, there in the number 32 machine. He is about to go one lap down to the number two of Marcus Richardson. Richardson working his way through lap traffic, got by Sifford, currently getting by Davis. Next up is going to be the 89 racing for Jesus Ford, Brian Wortman.
Beach is catching David Shutt by over a tenth a lap now, and that's going to be your battle for position on the racetrack as, you know, Richardson's working his way through all those inconsequential back markers. Another battle I think is going to start picking up is going to be Bobby Chaney and Tyler Ducharme. Chaney trying to chase him down on really similar lap times. Might be having Ducharme pull away a little bit because he really hates the tires he's got on the car that are taking two, but he might be able to reel him back in if the tire's even off for him. Microphone activated. That is not a place I want to be if I was Marcus Richardson in that small little group of lap cars on two tires. That would be evil.
Taking a look through the traffic, Richardson now your leader, the second spot occupied by David Shutt, way back there. Third now is Mr. Beach, closing absolutely fastly and stuff.
A tenth a lap fastly.
Mr. Beach catching David Shutt extremely fast.
Which
we should
is
see
thing.
That heating up here shortly. Fourth now is Tyler Ducharme, fifth Bobby Chaney, sixth. Final car on the lead lap, Nicholas Caressel. Aaron Davis, rather, scored in the 7th spot, 1 lap down. 8th is Brian Wortman, 1 lap down. 9th is Pertelli, 1 lap down. 10th is Randy Roberts, 1 lap down. 11th is Mark Arthur, scored 2 laps down. Sifford is 12th, 2 laps down. And 13th is Sergio Oliveira, 2 laps down.
Count. Wow, Beach right here on David Shutt. Shutt doesn't like to give up positions easily. He really likes to race really hard, so this could be very interesting.
This could be really bad. This is going to be terrible.
This could be our next caution. This could set up the rest of the race.
We see Beach right on the back bumper, intimidating the 12 a Shutt. Beach looking to the bottom of the tri-oval.
Making a move.
What kind of stupid shit is Shutt going to pull today?
He's got to get the run off the corner. He could. Shutt's not going to have the grip off the corner on the high side. Side by side down here to 3 and 4. Shutt's got almost the preferred line. He's really close. If he could get any closer to Beach's door, he'd be right on it. Looks like Beach is going to clear him here. And it looks like behind them we have a change in position between Bobby Chaney. I didn't look at the pace car. And Tyler Ducharme. Chaney's past him. Said earlier his tires are coming back to him. Well, there goes all the interesting stuff. Might as well go ahead and just throw the caution flag and throw the rest of the race. This is how they're going to finish.
Yeah. Thank you for joining us here at Sim Racing Authority TV. If you'd like to join the leagues, you can go to SimRacingAuthority.com as you see on the ticker up above. We also have information for our Facebook and our Twitter. Follow us, like us there, and then you'll know when we're going kneel to the wheel racing. Absolutely love to have you with us.
Gotta kneel down and deep throat that wheel every night.
You gotta praise the wheel, folks.
Praise the wheel!
Whoa.
Praise the wheel. Praise the wheel.
Right here we
maybe
have
one
of
maybe it's a mystery,
our...
maybe it's a wheel.
Exactly. Right here we have one of our satisfied drivers, Jeff Gordon. Jeff, just how was it when you found out about Sim Racing Authority TV?
Well, it was really nice when I found out about Sim Racing Authority. And, you should join it.
Oh my gosh, Jeff Gordon!
Hey, how's it going, Mr. Wine?
How's it going, Jeff Gordon?
Doing pretty good. Turns out I have AIDS. Yay. I'm like Tim Richmond.
Okay, that's enough of that.
I trusted you. Shouldn't do that. Full pucker. Pucker factor 211. I don't think Shutt's gone. I think he got behind Beach, found his line, and he's got the draft lock, and he's going to run right there behind him until he can make a move. Beach is actually gaining on Richardson, but not, I don't think, enough to finish up the rest of his... He's got 13 laps to go, and he's gaining them a little less than... Oh, never mind. Richardson pulled away again. Oh. So much for that story.
Yep. Well, your winner today is Marcus Richardson. You know, absolutely.
Might as well go ahead and interview him. Shit.
Yeah, why not?
Actually do that, because they might yell at you again. I don't know if you heard him earlier, but the drivers were all pitching about us, pulling him down and talking to him. So, especially Tyler Ducharme, because you know he just loves to be quiet during the race. So.
So, Tyler, we heard you were pretty unhappy about us pulling you down here in the middle of the race and talking to you. Just how pissed off are you about us talking to you during the race?
Don't think he's going to talk.
Okay. Now, Tyler, just how pissed off would you be if I were to ban you right now?
User in your channel was banned from the server.
I don't think he can get back in, so I kind of feel bad. Is he complaining in driver
chat? He's talking in race chat, don't worry.
I actually feel bad about that.
Nah, he's just racing with Bobby Chaney.
I think I just did everyone a favor, let's be honest here. Marcus Richardson, your leader. Yep. Second is Mr. Beach. Third is David Shutt. Fourth is Bobby Chaney. Fifth now is probably a very angry Tyler Ducharme. Sixth is Nicholas Caressel. Seventh is Aaron Davis. Having quite the battle right here with Brian... Well, actually, never mind. That's a different car.
Server group. I wish we had a debris caution button like Fox does. That'd be so nice. You see, we'll start to turn it over to, ABC News or something. You just press that little big... The little... the little big yellow button and just kapoosh and debris caution. All of a sudden, tape spawns up from the asphalt and they have a caution for it or something.
Yeah, 9 laps.
It'd be great
to
if
go.
We had that.
Here at Sim Racing Authority TV. Marcus Richardson is your leader.
9?
That's
really? Wow, that's too many.
That's too many. It really is.
Shut is still working Beach's back door.
Oh shit, I'm not allowed to ban people anymore. This sucks. What am I gonna do with my life? Anyway. Marcus Richardson, your leader. Second is Mr. Beach. Third is David Shutt. Fourth, Bobby Chaney. Fifth is Tyler Ducharme.
I mean, I would talk.
Oh, Ducharme getting loose coming off of turn 2. Almost hit the inside wall. That would have been amazing. He's going to merge here in turn 3. That right there is the number 20. They are not a battle for position at the moment. The 20 is, I do believe, Mark Arthur right there in the 12th spot. Currently scored 2 laps down right there, right in front of Tyler Ducharme. Tyler doesn't like it when lapped cars get in his way. Similarly,
Tyler doesn't like anything. You could give Tyler a birthday cake and he'd complain about it.
Yeah, you probably would. But your leader now by 3.2 seconds is Marcus Richardson. The real battle, as per usual here at Sim Racing Authority TV, is going to be for the second spot. These races would be so much more enjoyable if we just said screw it and banned Marcus because he is too fast.
I'm pretty sure we should just award the most points to second place.
Yeah, that's a good call too.
Give first place points to second and second place points to first. That'd be perfect. We should do that.
That would actually be cool.
I'm going to talk to Austin. Anyways.
That would be cool. Like, actually think about it. Because then you'd have people, like, trying to go slow, but then the third place guy would start catching them. Oh, dude. Just think about
it. We talk to Austin. That'd be fun for me to go to wheeler races. Man, you're not going to see Shot get any closer to Beach, because if he does, he's going to hit him. Well, you might see him get a little bit closer. But getting close to the end here, you're going to start seeing him think about making a move for real. Because as terrible as Shutt is, he's not the worst driver out there. He knows how to make a move, and he might use Aaron Davis up here with the anti-aero Boris said afro on the front of the car to use him as a pick and maybe get past him. It could be really interesting to see how this plays out. Because Beach can do some good crossover moves. He's done it to me a few times, and he might just let him go and cut down below him and get him on exit. We have to see here. Depends on how much chess they're willing to play for second place.
Yeah, here we are on board with David Shutt. Shutt is able to arc it all the way out to the wall right there going into turn 1, whereas Beach has to get to the inside of the 32. Could Shutt get the run off the corner? No. His plan backfired. Now here he is side by side with the 32 heading into turn 3. They're going to be about equal going into turn 3. Now Shutt right on the back bumper of Mr. Beach. 2 laps to go here at Atlanta. As they pass by the flag stand, the flagman is not in the stand. He's in a rush to grab that white flag right now. Hopefully he'll actually be able to make it to the flag stand in time to display that white flag. Shut it again into the back bumper of Beach. They hold on to it, and they are still going to be able to... That was net code. That was all net code.
That was scary.
Alright, well, there goes any form of plot for the last lap. Your finishing order today is going to be Marcus Richardson, your winner. Second is going to be Mr. Beach. Third is David Shutt. Well, wait.
Wow.
We see Aaron Davis heading to the inside of Beach right there.
Wow, that's totally for position, not.
Could Shutt possibly make a final move here at 3 and 4?
Oh my god! What? 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 Well, David Shutt coming home second place.
You know, Beach...
That's... Wow.
Beach and Aaron. Aaron got Beach back. We expected it to happen, and in fact, it did. So, let's see. I want to see if there's any retaliation here from the 22. No. Beach doesn't usually get mad at that kind of stuff. Your winner today is Marcus Richardson. Second is Mr. Beach. Third is David Shutt. Fourth is Bobby Chaney. Rounding out your top five is Tyler Ducharme. We'll go over the full results here after the interviews. Let's talk to some drivers. David Shutt, I'm assuming you still don't have a microphone. So, I'm going to talk with Bobby Chaney. Bobby Chaney, you got a copy?
Yep.
You know, you brought it home in the fourth spot right there. We heard you struggling right there on the two tires. If you could go back and do it all again, would you have taken four or taken no tires there on that last pit stop?
If anything, I would take none, but I pretty much was going to get where I'm at. I mean, where I finished was where I was going to get. Because Beach and Shutt were way faster than me, but hey, the two tires helped. I picked up track position and come home with another top five.
Certainly not a bad points day for the number 24, Bobby Chaney right there. Mr. Beach, you got a copy, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, Aaron Davis screwed you over tonight, that is for sure right there. Aaron Davis got to your inside right there for literally no reason going into turn three. You had to go high, and David Shutt was able to sneak by right there on the inside and pick up the second spot here today. Tell us about those last few laps. Tell us about those last few laps right there, Mr. Beach, where you made contact with David Shutt.
Let me explain it. Aaron Davis did nothing. I bit him fast mid-eye on the inside. I kind of screwed my turn three. I was pretty tight, and I had to release, and I think Shutt did not see that, so we hit. And I gave him his second place. He deserved it.
So what you're saying is we need to blame Beach?
Yeah.
10-4. All right, Marcus Richardson, your car is blown up. You destroyed the motor. You're not going to be bringing that chassis back here. Well, maybe the chassis, not the motor, though. Either way, bringing it home, the winner. Tell me, was it salty or sweet?
I don't know, I guess it was pretty sweet. It was a good race, besides whatever happened there in that, like, first or second lap, that looked pretty bad. Looked like someone got punted or went into the infield, but other than that, it was a really good race.
Yeah, there you go, you are our winner today. Absolutely amazing run right there. Not really anyone really had a chance. Looks like you made the right calls on pit road. Beach was a little bit faster there, but this place, the draft lock is just so intense. You ended up bringing home the win and a mildly destroyed race car. So, good run there, Marcus. Well.
Thank you.
I hit the mute button for the wrong thing. That is going to conclude our coverage.
Scott.
Here at Sim Racing Authority TV, taking a look at the final results. Marcus Richardson, your winner. David Shutt bringing it home second. Third is Mr. Beach. Fourth is Bobby Chaney. Fifth is Tyler Ducharme. Sixth is Nick Caressel. Aaron Davis. Seventh, eighth is Brian Wortman. Ninth is Tyler Sifford Pertelli in the 10th spot. 11th is Randy Roberts. 12th is Mark Arthur. Oliveira, 13th. 14th is David Fish. 15th is Alex Peck. 16th is Connor Anton Simpson. 17th, 18th is McMillan. Wyans and Redmond, the two pros. Winding out.
I beat you. I beat you.
I hate you so much.
Yeah. All that matters.
All right. Any closing thoughts here from Atlanta?
Hurry up and follow at LeagueSRA on Twitter. Go to SimRacingAuthority.com.
Yep. Join our
watch league. Our videos on YouTube because can.
Yeah.
Thank God. Don't ever watch us again at Atlanta because this track is boring to commentate and race on and everything is terrible. Oh.
Really was.
David Shutt's doing donuts for no good reason because he didn't win. He, all intents and purposes, came in third. also, sorry to Matt Simpson for saying you would win the race because that made you finish last car that started the race. That or you suck. I'm not really sure. Either one.
Tyler Ducharme sucks, unfortunately. All right.
Also,
well,
you close it because you and don't end the stream before you're done talking, you scrub. You do that every night.
Okay, we're just going to sit here for, like, quietly for, like, 25 seconds before I turn it off then.
Okay. It's going to cut me off.